Hello and welcome. I know it wouldn't take long enough before hand, foot and mouth disease would overtake Jamaica. After all, every day somebody in Jamaica put their foot in their mouths. Now they have added their hands to all the various things they can put in their mouth. That was a joke, okay? But on a serious note, there is a serious outbreak of the highly contagious disease in early childhood institutions among young children. WebMD says hand, foot and mouth disease is an illness that causes sores in or on the mouth and on the hands, feet, and sometimes the buttocks and legs. The sores may be painful. The illness doesn't usually last more than a week or so. It is common in children, but can also occur in adults. It can occur at any time of the year, but it is most common in the summer and in fall. It is caused by a virus called an enterovirus. The virus spreads easily through coughing and sneezing. It can also spread through infected stool, such as when you change a diaper or when a young child gets stool on his or her hands and then touches objects that other children put in their mouths. Often, the disease breaks out within a community. And it usually takes 3 to 6 days for a person to get symptoms of hand, foot and mouth disease after being exposed to the virus. This is called the incubation period. I'm saying all of this to say that this leads me to the opposition spokesperson on health and education, Marlene Malahu Fort and Kamina Johnson Smith, both of whom were very sensible before they came into politics. They held a joint press conference and blasted the ministries of education and health for not being proactive enough. I would have really liked both of them to tell me what Ronnie Thwaite should I do or what Fenton Ferguson should I do. Anyone who has ever had a child and sent them to nursery knows that the child is almost bound to come home with something they never had, including bite marks. They are little children and they cough and sneeze all over each other. And if you leave them to clean themselves after the bathroom, more than likely, if they are not supervised, they are going to bring back germs from the dirty toilets and they are going to pass it on. I don't know if proactive means that both ministers should supervise children going to bathroom in early childhood institutions, or that the ministers have some Gestapo agents that they can dispatch at the first sign of the disease to shut down school. I'm grasping for straws here because I don't know what they mean when they said the government did not act quickly. It's rubbish outbursts like these that continue to absolve parents of their responsibilities because it is politically cute to foist it on politicians. My humble advice to both of you is that Mrs. Malahu Fort, go back to the bench. I'm certain you will have more success there. And Mrs. Johnson Smith, open a law practice. You might make it big there. I might even come to you both for legal representation. But right now, Lloyd D'Aguila seems a better choice. Until you convince me otherwise, I will stay close to the edge.